team. Hope you guys enjoyed my drive to the gym. Let's get this day started. Morning sessions are done, and guess what I get to go do? I get a 90-minute massage. I'm so excited. It's gonna be painful, but you work hard, you reward yourself. 90-minute massage.
It's time to get naked, because I need to get a massage.
Intermission time. Look at my sweet robe. Halfway there.
That way?
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. All right, so we just got done with the massage. This is getting a massage. You shouldn't be going there just for the feel-good benefits. We're trying to get an end result. So I tell Dory my feedback. She looks at that feedback and is able to fix what's going on with me. So in that last session, okay, we were dealing with my neck, we were dealing with my right upper back and trap, and then we were working on my lower back and my glutes. And so those are some of the things, but today we had a few, those were improved and they didn't need as much work. But today we really focused on a few other parts. I'll let Dory kind of talk about that.
We focused on the feet, and we definitely found the right foot had some abnormal little feels to it. So we kind of scraped through it and massaged through that. And then into the shoulder, there wasn't as much in the neck, but more under in the shoulder blade, like more a lower trap.
It feels good to know that, okay, so the work that I've been doing on my lower back, the work I've been doing on my upper trap, on my right shoulder, the work I've been doing on my pec minor has been working, because there wasn't as much feedback whenever she worked on them. There wasn't as much work to be done, which is very exciting. So that just means positive reinforcement that I'm doing things right, keep moving forward with that, and then be proactive with my feet, my calves, and just keep it going. So yeah, thank you so much, Dory. Appreciate it. She's awesome. So if you live in the Fernandina Beach area, definitely check out Dory Chauncey Coastal Massage.
The post massage feels when you put your socks on and you're walking and your toes are like squishy. I'm just like one big oily mess right now. I feel like one of those pool noodles. All right, team, so I think it's only fitting that I do it for the pizza and I make a pizza. So today we're gonna be making a stuffed crust, macro-friendly pepperoni pizza.
Right over here by the window, we're gonna let it rise.
And since we gotta let this dough sit about an hour or two, I'm gonna make a little snack. It is currently 1:30, I have not eaten anything. So I'm gonna make a little snack. I'll let it be a little surprise. Is that a s'mores protein pizookie? And you add that scoop of the s'mores halo top. Then some of that Walton Farms marshmallow fluff on top. There it is. All the toppings, got the marshmallow fluff that's falling off, but it's still gonna be unreal. Ice cream, oh man. This is just naughty. Look at that chocolate chip right there. Oh man, that is just it's just not fair. The s'mores cookie cake. Fill the middle with that Walton Farms marshmallow fluff. And there's that cookie cake, the s'mores halo top just melting everywhere. Oh man. We take our spoon. Oh man. It's like a freaking lava cake. Unreal. Look at the cookies. Now, as you can see,
yes.
Looks like a big old brain. Beat it down with the heel of your hand.
And now we got this huge piece of pizza dough.
There she is in all her beauty. Oh my gosh.
Dough time.
Oh my gosh.
All right, so now the moment I know I've been waiting for.
That live taste test, look at that freaking crust.
I'm gonna take a bite of the front and then a bite of the crust.
And you're met with all those cheese gains? Like what?
All right, so we got our pizza gains right here. We got our Google Doc that I'm sharing with my editor. And we have our salad gains. So now I'm gonna add the stuffed crust pepperoni pizza.
All right, team, so fast forward, it is now 5:30 p.m. I'm sorry I haven't filmed as much as I wanted to today. I filmed the rest, just been running around. It would just be you driving and walking to places with me. I had to go get my passport, well, apply for my passport today, get my picture taken. I had to go to my local CPA's office. I had to go to my computer repair guy who's upgrading all the software and RAM on my computer. I think you might have saw that clip. I had to send out a few packages. I had to, obviously, I had to finish that pizza recipe, which is the last recipe in the book. Tonight we finalized the book. Like, I'm so freaking excited. You see how good that stuffed crust pizza was? Like, that's insane. That's insane. And so it's now 5:30. I'm heading back to the gym. We have two consults tonight that I gotta do, and then we head back home and finish things up. So today was just a day that I did a lot of things outside of the gym. But if you've noticed, all I've had today, I've been up since, so when you saw this morning I was up at, that was around 6 a.m. And so I got done with my sessions at the gym, went to my massage, which was at 10:30. And then I got done with my massage around 12. I didn't eat my first piece of food till around 2 o'clock. And so then I had those pizookies, both the s'mores pizookie and s'mores cookie cake. And then I also had, I had my pizza with that side salad. And so it's about 5:30 now. So I'm just so busy, I get so sidetracked. It's just, my nutrition fits my lifestyle. If you want to intermittent fast, that's fine. As long as it fits your lifestyle, to make it. Don't stress yourself out. It's my nutrition fits my lifestyle. Am I maximizing muscle protein synthesis? Probably not. Do I care? Not really. So it is what it is. You just gotta weigh that. Do you want to maximize as much muscle you want to put onto your frame? Then eat a protein serving 4 to 6 times a day. Spread it out between every 4 hours. And if you don't, just fit your nutrition into your lifestyle. It's that simple. It's that simple. So I'll talk to you guys soon. Dinner is about to be served. Look at this beautiful white cheddar queso cheese sauce being made up right now. So excited. Oh, just look how beautiful those are. All right, so here's the lineup. We got our 3 whole eggs, we got a sliced tomato, we got our sauteed veggies, got a big old egg white omelet. All right, so we've now added our sauteed broccoli, red and green peppers, and tomato. Cheese sauce is now on there. And it looks good. So now we fold it over the omelet. As you can see, it's not the prettiest thing I've ever created, but it's gonna taste amazing. All right, so we've now made this big monster. We've added our 3 whole eggs on top, the buffalo sauce. This thing is ugly, but it's gonna taste amazing. Bada bing. Ooh. Bada boom. Ooh. And bada the shadam. Bam. So here's that end product. Just added all the veggies on there.
So now we got this big plate full of tasty gains. Oh shoot. Orange creamsicle protein ice cream. And we add that chocolate Walden Farms. Then the final touch of that fruity ice cream pebbles rainbow sherbet on top, and a little bit more Walden Farm.
Of course, that live taste test. Just look at that. Chocolate covered orange creamsicle gains. That drip coming. Ooh. Here we go. No shame. No shame.
Like, look at that bite, man. This doesn't get much better than that, my friends. When you get your Walden Farms order in, and you are just so psyched. Walden Farms has my back. I mean, look. We got my caramel, we got my French vanilla creamer, we got my pancake syrup, caramel dip, marshmallow dip, chocolate syrup, strawberry syrup, mocha creamer, sweet cream, and then look at how many other bottles we have, just so I don't run out. That's one order, my friends. This is every month. Tell me Walden Farms doesn't have my back. I love you guys. All right, so the only crappy part is I gotta take all those and put them all in those boxes. Can't just leave them out like this. All right, so we got all of our bottles and dips all in their boxes. Now I gotta go put these away. All right, but before I do, I just wanna sign off and say thank you so much for watching. If you watch this point in the video, it means so much to me. And I wanna say thank you for going through my day today and just, and taking an interest in what's going on. I truly appreciate it. I try to provide as much value as I can, and I hopefully I am. So, as always, thank you so much for watching. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Please give the video a thumbs up. It really does help the channel. Please subscribe, and please share the channel with anybody you think could benefit. We got some cool recipes, so at least share those. And as always, thanks and God bless, my friends. I'll see you next time.